Hi, Curt Sinclair here with Illinois 4-H. I love to go outdoors any time of year, and winter is one of those times when it's just awesome to be an outdoorsman or go outside, have fun, get some fresh air. Before you do anything on a body of water with ice though, I want to really quickly, a couple minutes, tell you some basic safety tips that actually could save your life. First thing is, understand that new ice is a lot stronger than old ice. New versus old. New means within the last few days. If it freezes hard and you get a good 4 inches of ice thickness, then you can safely get on new clear ice that's at least 4 inches thick with a person, a buddy of yours can go out, you can go out on 4 inches of ice. Okay, the newness means it's stronger than if it's been there a long time and thawed and refroze and thawed and refroze and over several weeks. That's not near as strong as ice. The clear versus the cloudy, you can see this ice that I'm on right here is pretty cloudy. It has had some snow on it that has melted and then refrozen. So basically the cloudiness is impurities in the ice, which is mostly air, but it's just not as strong. It's only about half as strong as brand new clear ice. So if you've got cloudy ice, make sure you have more thickness than if it's clear ice. 4 inches of clear ice, okay, for a person. Now to get a four-wheeler or some other small piece of equipment out on a lake or a river or something that's frozen, you need more than 4 inches. You need 5 to 6 inches. If you're going to get a vehicle on the ice, which is not unheard of, particularly in northern Illinois, where it's going to get colder longer, you know, more frequently, you're going to need 12 inches of ice for that. But just generally to access it for skating, for ice fishing, 4 inches of good, clear ice that's relatively new. Okay, those are the tips for you. Now, before you go out, a couple pieces of equipment for your safety. None of this stuff is expensive or complicated either. First item is to have a rope with you. If you're on your own, tie it to something on the bank and take the rope out with you. In case something would happen, that you can pull yourself out with this. If that somehow wasn't enough, or you didn't have a rope near you, or you're trying to get out before your buddy got you the rope, these are the simplest and most easy to make yourself at home. These are called ice picks. And basically, there's just some sort of string that lets them hang conveniently with you the whole time. I use an old closet rod. You could use an old broom handle or even just a 2x2 square. But it's your wooden handled grip. Drive a nail in the end, cut the flat part of the nail off with a metal hacksaw, and you've got something that if you fell in, you'd be able to, first of all, if you do fall in, your body is going to have a hard time adjusting for 30 seconds, 45 seconds. This is going to be hard to breathe. And during that time, you're going to want to try to remain as calm as you can. You are not going to sink because you're going to have your life jacket on just like you would in the boat in the summer. Wear this underneath your clothing. It's foam and it's a vest and it's going to help keep you warm anyway. But that would keep you floating. Get your breath. Get your ice picks. Hopefully while somebody's throwing a rope to you or going to get the rope if they haven't already. But these will allow you to jab and pull yourself out onto the ice. Okay, so we have talked about new ice, old ice, clear ice, cloudy ice, some of the gear. But what I want to finally wrap up with is that you need to understand ice is not going to be the same over the whole lake. A lot of factors at play here. Shallow water can absorb heat as the sun can get to the bottom, warm that column up. So a lot of times the shallow end of your lake is not going to have as much ice. Anytime you have moving water of any kind, whether it's a current in a river or the water coming in through a tile or through just the runoff of the lay of the land, the moving water is going to keep ice from getting as thick every time. So moving water, be very, very conscious if you know that there's a spot, there's moving water, okay? So you just need to understand that ice can be radically different from just a few feet away. A test hole 10 feet away from another one can give you way different results. That's usually got to do with environmental factors for moving water. So pay attention to the details, use the safety gear, always have an emergency plan. People know where you are. Go with a friend. Do all those smart things and enjoy the outdoors. Curt Sinclair for Illinois 4-H. See you outside.